Welcome to Seely Training, and I am Jason Seely. I need to show you one of the coolest things that Microsoft has just recently added. If you go on to your admin center in Office 365, you can click on the Skype for Business link, and something that they've added is really slick. Been waiting for this for almost a year. It's basically under this call routing area, and it is actually an auto attendant. So if you've been able to set up your phones and have people use headsets to be able to communicate back and forth to each other, that's wonderful. And you know, people can make calls and you can receive calls. But one of the things that's been missing is your main line and the ability to take your incoming calls, route them to customer service, to salespeople, whatever it might be, and have a menu for that. So this is what they've done. They've added this capability. So for example, I'm gonna go into one of our main lines that we've set up and edit it. And in the auto attendant configuration area, this is what you'll see. You give it a name, you assign one of your phone numbers, and you can actually select that number from any of the added service numbers. You have your Skype user numbers and you have service numbers, and it gives you a limited number of those. So you can add a phone number and you can set it up there, or you can port your main line over and actually make it work that way. Set up your time zone, set the language. You can turn on speech recognition, which allows the callers that call in to actually say a name, and it will detect that and automatically connect to that line, that extension. Then you can establish an operator and assign somebody that's listed in your group list. Over on the left here, you've got hours of operation. You can actually pick 24/7, or you can set it up to custom and pick a block of time that you might want to make it available. Then under business hours call handling, this is where the good stuff comes in. So you can choose to have a company greeting, and it gives you the option to create a custom greeting or upload an audio file. So the nice thing is, if you just come in here and type in, hello, this is so-and-so company, press 1, 2, 3, whatever you want to say, you can actually record that as a, or enter it as a text, and the system will automatically read it through the computer voice, which is pretty cool. The other option you can do is you can set it up as a audio file and then just upload that. It doesn't matter what it is, because that's what's being presented when the person calls in and it answers the first message that they'll hear. So based on whatever you tell them, they can then select from a list. So in this situation, what happens to the calls after the greeting? You can disconnect, you can redirect the call, or you can play a menu, which is what we've done in this situation. When you select this, you can change it to a custom prompt, or again, you can upload an audio file. So separate from your main call-in, you can actually have a menu that is an audio file or typed in. And in this case, we've typed in, if you know the name of the person you want to reach, say it at any time. For the shipping department, press 1. For other site service, press 2. Customer service, 3, etc. So you can put in whatever menu you want. You can turn on the ability to dial my name, and you can see right here it enables callers to reach people by name. Then you just click on the buttons that you would actually have that person press, and then you define each one of those buttons with what its name is. That can just be whatever generic name you want to give it. You can tell it it's a person in the company if it's going to an individual person. Or you can have it go to a call queue, which I'll show you in a second, or you can have it wrap back around into another auto attendant. So it gives you the ability to select from any of those. And then you put the name or the group or whatever auto attendant you're trying to connect to or call queue. And then finally, you have a dial scope. This gives you the ability to include your entire AD list, or you can exclude certain names from the list if you don't want people to be able to select those from the menu. You hit save, and your auto attendant's ready to go. Let's come over here and take a look at call queues. I'm going to click add. You can actually give it a name. This is real similar to the auto attendant. You can give it an assigned number. You can pick which domain you want to choose if you have multiple domains in your Office 365 environment. And in this case, it wants you to select from a greeting, and it apparently only allows you to upload an audio file. It doesn't let you type in the text that you want to read. You can tell it you want music on hold. You can create a distribution list in your AD environment and actually assign that as the call agents. And then you can tell it the maximum number of calls you want in the queue. So what this is essentially for is, let's say you're a sales group and you have a call-in line. It goes to the main menu. You hit an option to get to a sales group, and then it puts you in a round robin queue or a pool of up to 50 calls at one time. And what those callers will hear is that on-hold music after they hear the intro, and they'll sit in that queue, and you can tell it how long you want them to be there, for a maximum of 20 minutes. When the maximum number of calls is reached, in other words, if too many people are trying to connect, what do you want to do? Just disconnect them, forward them to yet another call number, leave a message, whatever you want to do. And then you can limit the length of time. And when it's all done, they've reached that time limit, you can disconnect. So you can have multiple queues. You just keep creating lists of them. And then with your auto attendant, you can actually direct to the queue that you want to based on different criteria. So if you think about all the power that you have here, you've got a lot of flexibility. You can create multiple auto attendants. You can create multiple queues. You can direct to individuals, to AD groups, to call queues with multiple people. Very flexible. And when you wrap all the pieces together, when you're calling that main line, you're actually going to have this menu system that redirects people around wherever you want to go. Very cool. Very, very desirable feature. One of the main things that Microsoft's been asked to add to the Skype phone capability. And so far, I would give it an A+. Excellent. This is Seeley Training. Hope you enjoy what you've watched in this video. Please subscribe with the link below. And if you like this video in particular, click the like button. That helps as well. Thank you very much.